Late Show, the CBS alternative to entertainment.
You said it.
I'm being heckled from behind. Also by Jeff. My next guest is a columnist and author. He's got a new book out. It's called Man-Made, The Stupid Quest for Masculinity. It's in stores May the 15th. Please welcome the lovely and attractive Joel Stein, everybody. Joel Stein. I know you from not being here, and look at you here wearing a tie and a suit. You look great.
They give you makeup and hair.
Yes.
And I took some things that I think were free. I'm not sure.
What things are we talking about?
There was like a tiny deodorant.
Yeah.
That's okay?
That's for little people.
Oh, that makes sense. That makes sense now. I'll put that back.
Yeah, because you use it once, it's used up. Are you a very sweaty man? Do you smell bad?
Just on television.
No, you smell great right now.
Really? I was concerned.
No, you smell really good.
I wanted to smell good for you.
Why?
I don't know, because you're so unnaturally close in this situation. I felt like my breath should smell.
Am I very close? Is I creepy close?
When you talk to people in real life, you're not this close, are you?
Yeah, no. This is not too close. Is this close?
Close.
Really?
Yeah, in fact.
What was this
better? Yes, this is much better. Yes.
Hey, this book looks sensational. Look, it's
pretty.
Yeah, it's got all this in the front. It's got a fireman's hat.
Things.
Yeah. Why is it, what's it about then, Joel? You can write a bit, I know that about you.
I freaked out when I found out I was having a son, because I'm not equipped to raise a boy.
Yeah, of course you are. Look at you, look great.
Look at me. No, he's going to want to like go camping and get in fights and do sports and watch sport. I'm not capable of any of that. Yeah. So, I had a glass animal collection as a kid. I had an Easy Bake Oven as a kid.
Did you really?
Yeah, I only listened to musicals. I'm a little scared of that snake. I'm not equipped at all.
What are you talking about, man?
A little bit.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you frightened of snakes?
I didn't know you were down to one fang. I've never noticed that on television. That was a bad day.
It's the only snake on TV with British teeth. Don't start now.
Oh, that's right.
You wrote a book to raise your son by?
I wanted to go learn how to be a man before he was born, so I did very manly things.
Put on a fireman's hat?
I did a stint as a fireman for
10 years. Did you really?
Yeah, I was in the army for 3 days in boot camp.
What?
And I
3 days?
I fought Randy Couture, the UFC fighter.
You fought Randy Couture?
He fought me, but yeah.
How did that turn out? Because Randy's been here, and I wouldn't fight him.
No, he's very intimidating. I thought we would kind of talk and have fun first, and he went right in with me.
Wait, that's the guy's job, man. He's like, he wants to get it done. And you know that Randy Couture doesn't like fighting. That's what he said. I said, I don't like fighting. I just want to win, get it over with, and get out the door. I just want to get done.
He seemed to enjoy it with me.
Well, he might have enjoyed it a bit with you. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, but no, he's never been in a street fight. I got hurt. Dana White, the guy who runs UFC, trained me before, and I got hurt during that. He wanted to choke me out, so I knew what it felt like. If he's on the show, don't let him do that.
I wouldn't let anyone choke me out unless they can choke me out.
Right. No,
by the way, choke me out, that's not code for anything else, is it? I only asked because you had a glass animal collection as a kid. So you were an ultimate fighter, and you were a fireman. Did you go to called out in any fires?
We did in LA. The firefighters are also the ambulance. So most of what they do is take people to the hospital who don't need to go to the hospital. Mm. But they're excited for. I thought they wouldn't want to go to fires because it's a fire.
It's dangerous. Yeah.
It turns out that's all they want to do all day. And if they miss a fire, they're just dejected for the entire week.
Well, how could you miss a fire if you're a fireman? That makes you a terrible fireman. Ah, I was sleeping.
When there's an actual fire, you will see 10 fire trucks racing to it because they all want to be there first.
Well, good. That's what you want in your fireman.
No, because they could be stuck at a hospital, like waiting for some patient to be admitted, and then they miss the fire, and then they're sad all week.
I see. Yeah. If I was a fireman or involved in the firefighting game,
right.
Once I dropped them off at the hospital, I'd be like, gotta go.
Right.
There could be a fire.
Exactly. That's what they want to do, and they can't legally, so they're very frustrated.
Oh, that must be annoying. Yeah. But what else did you do? Did you do what manly things? Chef?
I did, but I didn't put it in the book. I went to the barbecue competition, and I was embedded with a team competing.
Embedded with a barbecue team?
Yeah, they're serious.
Do you feel you're more manly at the end of this book?
Look at me.
It's true, man. I actually
know
you. No, I know you from outside of here, and I've never seen you wear a tie, so...
No, I learned that,
look
too.
At you. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, no, I feel manly.
Did you tie that tie yourself?
I had some help. But I started it myself.
Right.
Yeah, then the Windsor, I got confused.
Yeah, the Windsor, it's a Windsor knot?
It's a half Windsor.
This is a half Windsor.
Is it? We got to man up and go full Windsor, don't you think?
No, no, half Windsor's enough for me.
Really? It's punkier, it's a little, yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of like, also, it's very, I mean, I don't know how to do anything else.
That's me neither. All. My dad taught me this one knot, it's all I got.
Right, that's, you don't want to be one of those guys that has a fancy tight tie. You look like some kind of riverboat gambler. Well, I say, my name is Cat Dander.
You have a riverboat character all like in the chamber that?
Apparently, I have a riverboat gambler character inside me called Cat Dander. My name is Cat Dander, and I will take your money, sir.
I'm going to predict he's going to become a regular on the show.
I think that he's going to arrive. What do you think, Jeff?
Oh, I say, I declare he will.
Well, I do declare I... Well, yes.
He stole your character.
Oh, he does that all the time. I used to be a gay robot skeleton. Now look who's the gay robot skeleton. So, you wrote a book about being a man.
I did.
You became more of a man. Is your son impressed?
Not so much. Yeah. He's, so I thought I'd have this kid who was into sports and fighting and camping.
Yeah, he's your kid.
Well, because my wife's not Jewish.
Your wife's not Jewish?
Yes. So I thought the odds were that he'd come out more like her. And he looks like a little Gestapo, but he acts like a Jew. He is. You should see him. He's very tall and blonde, and he's not old enough to watch Stay Up This Late. He won't see this.
Man, stop with him. I'm worried about him, man. All right, we're out of time, Joel.
Thank you.
Mouth organ, awkward pause, or do you want to go for the big cash prize?
Do you know awkward pause is actually a journalistic trick? It's a skill you learn as a journalist.
Really? I had no idea.
Yeah.
Really? Is it a journalistic trick?
Yeah, because if you're quiet and someone else is talking, they'll start to reveal more stuff. People want to fill awkward pauses and tell you about their childhood and the troubles they had and how they had class animal collections and no friends, and their parents had to bribe them to play with other kids by giving them more TV, and they were lonely. They really questioned their sexuality for a bit. Stuff like that. People just start revealing stuff. How they are perhaps oddly attracted right now to a Scottish man they're sitting next to. Trick like that.
Yeah, it's a good one. I'd give you the $50, but I think Kelly Preston took all of it.
Did she smuggle it in her dress?
Oh, that was all her, man.
Really? Yeah. That is impressive.
That's a very attractive.
Oh my God.
Oh, hey, look at that. Look,
people just bring you bags of money on the show?
No, Joel. They bring you bags of money. Joel.